TotalRock at Wacken, day four, the last day, Saturday, joined by Noa and Yotam.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you there?
How are you feeling? You've been here all weekend.
And a bit more.
A little bit more, okay. Ah, because you are judges for the battle metal for Iran. Yeah?
Yeah, Iran, I don't think they like that though. No, just for Israel this year.
Oh, Israel.
And but Iran should send a metal band to the metal battle. Because I'm sure the Iranian scene has a lot to offer.
Mm. Yeah, I think I saw an Iranian band at Bloodstock last year.
There you go.
Yeah. So how was your heat, your competition? How many bands did you have?
In 28.
In the international one?
Just in Israel.
Just in Israel, we had around 20 bands trying to participate, or a bit more. And we picked out of them, we picked 8 for the semi-finals, and out of them we brought 5 and the winners of last year to make a great in a big venue with a big crowd, like around a bit more than 300 people, to participate in the small bands of this Israeli lovely little scene. And from that we sent Shiran, the winning band of the Israeli Metal Battle for 2018, who are great. If you haven't, check it out. Shiran's band.
Shiran. Okay. Was that an easy choice? Or
no,
tough?
It wasn't.
Not
easy
at all. The level was very high in the finals. I mean, most of the bands were really great. And I, as a judge, had a very hard time choosing. I couldn't actually decide until I literally said Shiran's name. So, yeah. But I'm very happy that we sent Shiran. I think they represented Israel in the best way. They bring something a little bit different than what you usually see in the international battle. They bring melodies and a wonderful, amazing, charismatic female front. Yeah, great show, great energies, charisma, which is very important.
So yeah. Was this the first year you've done this, the competition?
No.
Actually, the Metal Battle in Israel is now 10 years old.
Whoa!
Back in 2008, we won first place. And also in 2011, we got to the top 5 in 2015, 2009. And we barely made it to the top 5 this year. We got to the 6th place, which is honorable. But almost there.
Almost there.
And this is the final, the World Cup final here at Wacken.
Yeah, basically, yes. Yeah. Or some kind of, as Thomas Jensen, the founder of Wacken, they used to call it, it's the Olympics of metal.
Yeah, Olympics, that'll do. The Metal Olympics.
Yeah.
Amazing. Nice. I have a party at home. I do Eurovision, but with metal bands.
Yeah, and we already won the Israel won the Eurovision this year, so it's okay. 6th place is fine.
Do you know what? I saw that and I thought, that's the winner. That's right. I got it.
Yeah.
How's backing you? What do you think to that song?
Yeah, what?
What do you think to that song?
The song?
Yeah.
I think it brings a lot of energies, but the really funny part about Netta Bazilai, the winner of the Eurovision contest, is her brother used to play in a metal band that participated in this year metal battle in the Israeli finals, a thrash metal band called Scenery. Because there it's not just a small scene, basically it's a small country. So even though like everything brings us a little bit of pride,
it's literally a family.
Yeah, a really big family.
Yeah,
it
even
is.
With a lot of black sheep. Yeah, but
but good black.
Well.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And you have a charity as well. Is that right?
Yeah. You talk about it.
Yeah, we have a non-profit called Shevet. It means tribe.
Like the 12 tribes. So we're the 13, the unlucky ones.
Nice. That's my lucky number, 13.
And if I don't know, we said that it's a family. It's like a tribe. Everybody knows everybody, and we want to give them like a home and support in every way we can. If it's a moral support or if it's actual helping them with videos, with shows. Promotion.
Basically, I think if I
booking, everything. Yeah.
It's like what record labels used to do back in the 80s and the 90s, but in a non-profit kind of way. And it's a non-profit label, basically, just like trying to helping the bands reach out. Since we don't have, it is basically a charity organization, we don't have a lot of funding. But
We don't have funding.
At
but
all.
But the thing is that we are musicians as well, both of us, and everybody else in Shevet is. We're only five people, but we're all we're all musicians in some way or another, and because we came from helping other musicians, and they helped us. So it was kind of already happening before Shevet was formed. We just made it official.
Okay.
And this is what we're trying to achieve, musicians supporting each other. So if you do a show and you want to do an event for three bands, everybody should contribute their part, and then it will be a profitable event. And then they will all even see something out of it, and they will be able to print their merch or record their album with this money. So this is why we manage without any funding from the outside. It's a new thing, so you have to start from something.
But
this is how we managed so far, even without funding from outside, to make it work. Just do it smart and cooperate with the right people and guide them with our humble experience. I don't know if it's that's the idea around it.
Yeah, if I may add, I think in this day and age, after you know the internet and like 18 years after Napster and stuff like that, the music industry is kind of in shambles. And what we do is, at least in Israel for now, we are taking the music back to the musicians. And
we
are helping each other in order to make it a bit less convoluted of an industry and make it more musician friendly, at least for the metal, because this is the genres we like anyway.
Nice. Okay, you mentioned the band as well. Playing the band, have you been in the band together?
Only
by force.
Well, we sometimes invite each other.
Yeah, we share stages. Noah plays in an amazing progressive metal band called Scardust. What are you doing? Shut up now. This is so not metal. No, this is all about Wacken. Wacken is looks like hell, feels like heaven.
Good one.
I should
it feels like
too.
Hell at the minute.
Yeah, so Scardust is I would call it progressive metal. What can you say about Scardust?
Scardust is
I'm always
a combination
ashamed of
between Symphony X, Arch Enemy, and a Disney score.
Wow.
Yeah, kind of.
That sounds epic.
It is epic.
Nice.
If the word epic wasn't like belong to other kind of genres, it is what I would describe it.
Epic metal.
And
Tony.
And again, a really big following in Israel. They already supported great bands like Epica, like Symphony X, Varion, a lot of other bands.
No way. Thank you.
Oh, that way then.
Yeah, we're known for performing with a choir. Because I'm,
I heard about that. A hooded choir.
I'm also a choir conductor. And so I bring my choir on stage, and when we compose the music, we have the choir in mind as the kind of the sixth member of the band. And we try to include them at least in every headline show.
Yeah, and it's outgrown now. It's like Hellscore, the choir, is now recorded the choir parts for the Amorphis album, for Orphan Land, and it's keep
like
on growing.
Like a separate entity almost.
Almost
like a separate entity.
It is now a separate entity.
It is.
They just made a few festival appearances in Estonia.
Yeah, we just came back from Estonia.
Covering metal songs, only with 22 singers.
A cappella. Yeah, without using any instruments.
Nice.
So, Hellscore.
Ghost last night.
Ah, damn, we just missed it.
So, Hellscore.
Timo Burgi is still performing tonight.
Check them out. And, and Scardust is my band, and Yotam's band is also an amazing mellow death,
mediocre band.
Mediocre metal.
They're called Pray for Nothing.
Pray with an E.
With an E.
Because it's like a play of word, but also the play of word is with an E.
Okay. play.
Scardust for Wacken next year.
Scardust for Wacken next year.
I guess you can't enter your own competition. Your judgment. Yeah,
exactly.
It always feels like that. Always the bridesmaid, never the bride.
But you know, a few years ago, when Yotam asked me to be his co-judge, he said that I have two choices. I can compete in the competition, or I can become his co-judge. And if I do one of them, I can't do the other, of course. And that's it for the rest of I will never be able to compete
in the
Metal Battle. I chose to be his co-judge because I feel like it's the right place for me to be involved with, like, in the actual, how would you say, Asiya?
I think also the Metal Battle is such a great platform for so many bands that I won't feel, she's a really good friend of mine, as you apparently already understand that, and I didn't feel like I couldn't let her participate and feel honest with myself. So I said, I know you have a really great band, I really believe in Scardust, but I don't think I will be able to be objective about it. And people will say like, oh, now you're just sending your friends to Wacken.
Yeah.
And so I said, I think you will be a great co-judge. So this is the professional thing I can do. But like, as a band member myself, I really want to perform in Wacken. We have to do it the hard way.
Yeah, it's the longer way, but I feel like it's the right way for us.
Of merit, it'll be.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, and I think the Metal Battle is still a great platform, and every band that participated in it has like the huge jumping point to a shiny new career in the metal community and worldwide. And just because we can do it doesn't mean we won't want to do it.
Yeah,
we want to go to Wacken, even like for a small stage like the Wasteland or something.
Even the campsite.
Yeah, even the campsite. She's done it already.
Yeah, 2013.
Yes.
Great, okay, so for next year, we're gonna definitely see you bring another band.
Yeah.
Maybe, we may see you play.
Oh, at least her. My face is too ugly.
Wear a mask. Ghost too.
I can also do an ugly face.
Cool. It's lovely to meet you. Enjoy the rest of your day, it's almost
over.
Thank
you.
And maybe we'll see you in the UK as well.
Hopefully.
Oh, you will. I promise you, you will see us in the UK.
Right.
At least help by the face, you won't recognize me with the mask.
Thank you.